head or in my sketchbook, finally pinning this idea I've been holding on for too long. Really rough, but their idea is like someone sitting in a fancy ass chair with a lamp and just looking through back his memories and just seeing the pages just fly out. Of course, I have the whole like heartbreak type shit, like someone just ripping off pages just because things they don't want to remember. Or just people just, there's just memories they wish they can remove from their head. I was losing someone, family member, or breaking up with someone. Just something everyone just goes through, like some like traumatic memory they don't want to remember. Because as we get older, we start losing memories and we start forgetting about things. So basically that's why you use the book for a representation of oneself, one's mind. If you don't take care of your book, it fucking rips apart, you know? There's a song that I felt like helped me out, like come up with ideas about this book series. And the lyrics are called Old Book by Real Friends. So it's, I'm treated like an old book that was left on the shelf. Everyone underlined what they wanted to read and forget the rest. My spine was left worn out and bent. So just take what you want from me and forget the rest. So yeah.
Perfect.
Yard companies, just because that's what my dad used to do.
Rental?
Yeah, he used to work with like those companies that let you rent out tractors and all those equipments they use for either landscaping or for construction. There's something that happened and I was the one that was giving the news, so I had to break it to everyone. And just as I told my family members, I just saw their hearts just thing. So I was the one that told my siblings what happened. I didn't witness it, but like I'm the oldest brother, so no person I knew English, so they told me first. So I had to break it to everyone. I had to break it to my grandma. This was at a location. My dad was out working and something happened and ended up losing him. If I don't take a risk and just try to improve on my art, it's never gonna happen. So I decided to leave my job, leave my hometown, and come to LA. Being an artist is pretty risky, because it all depends if people like your work or not. But everyone thought I was a good artist, except one person, and that was me.
You didn't have any confidence?
Nah, I wasn't at the level that I wanted to be. And I just try to keep learning and try to keep improving my skills. And as I got older and having jobs, it just takes a lot of that creative time away. You start less and less focusing on your art, more of paying the bills, too busy thinking about work and just stressing out. I have family in Gardena, so I would always come and visit them all the time. But then I see all these art shows and events. Well, there's some in San Diego. There's a lot more artists I'm more interested. They're all up in Los Angeles.
Right. San Diego seems like a smaller community of artists.
Yes, beach scenes and
the whole headlock is just like, yeah, fuck. But it's
rub paint on my face, that's all. But it's slowly growing, but